So students, in this video, in this lecture, I'll be discussing about the concept of splicing and some coder provisions of that. This is also very important because in GATE examination and other examinations also, this topic is very frequent, right? So now what is splicing? So let me explain you one thing. Let us say that this is a reinforcement bar. Okay, let us say I was casting a beam. Okay, I was casting a beam, or let us say, for example, I was casting a column. Now you must have seen that. Let us say I want to construct a second floor. But for not now, after let us say 2 years or 3 years or 5 years. So what I will do? Let us say these are the columns. So I will, you can say these bars you can see with the naked eyes, right? I will leave the bars as it is. Now, for example, this is the first floor. I have casted the slab and first floor is ready. Now, for second floor, I don't want the second floor now. But after 2 to 3 years, I will be constructing the floor. So what the people usually do, that they erect the columns halfway and they leave the reinforcement bar as it is. You can see the reinforcement bar also, right? In your vicinity also, you must have seen that on the roof slab, they have columns with the naked reinforcement bars, right? Now, after 2 to 3 to 4 years, when the second floor will be casted, so what will I do? I will use these reinforcing bars, and for example, the other reinforcing bar, they will be spliced together, right? So I can say that splicing basically means joining two bars. So when it is done, first, it is done when you are constructing, you can say, the other floor or the other structure after some time, or it is also done when the length of the reinforcing bar is not enough. So it is done in two ways or in two situations it is done. Okay. So for example, I am also drawing it. Let us say this is the first floor. Okay. This is slab of the first floor. This is column. This is the plinth level. And this is plinth level. This is column. This is column. This is first floor. Let us say this is first floor. And let us say after 2 years, I am planning to construct the second floor. So what I will do, when I have the first floor construction is done, now these columns will be extended and there will be some bars like this. You must have seen, right? There will be some bars like this, naked bars. Now when the second floor will be constructed after 2 to 3 years, now what I will do? Now I will make splice joints with the columns here. I will make a splice joint with the columns here. These are the columns. And here, the second slab has been casted. So these joints are known as the splicing or the splice joints. So this is situation number one. The second situation is when you have the length of the reinforcing bar is not enough. So what you do? You provide splicing, right? Now, there are some codal provisions which are very important. There are some codal provisions also. So what are the codal provisions? Let us see. The code says that, you cannot provide splicing at that section. Again, I'm repeating, you cannot provide splicing at that section where the moment it is actually more, 1 point, you can say 50% more than the moment of resistance, right? The code says that splicing should not be provided. Splicing, this is important point, that is why I'm writing it completely, right? Splicing should not be provided at sections where moment is greater than 50% of moment of resistance. Let us say the moment of resistance of the section was, let us say, 50 kilonewton meter. This was the moment of resistance. If at that particular section where you want to provide splicing, the moment you have calculated it is coming out to be 26 kilonewton meter, then you do not have to provide splicing. This is the first codal provision, right? The second coding provision is you should not provide splicing if the diameter of the bar, the reinforcement bar, it is greater than 36 mm. This is provision number 2 of IS 456. Both these provisions are very important. Now the question is, sir, if more than, if diameter is more than 36 mm, then if splicing should not be provided, what should I provide? So you should do welding. Simple, right? If diameter is more than 36 mm, do welding. No splicing should be provided. This question has been asked many times in theoretical examinations. Okay? The third important aspect of splicing. Okay? The lap length. Now, what is the lap length? Now, this is a splice. Let us say this is a splice. How splice is done? Let me draw it. This is one bar. This is bar number 1 and this is bar number 2. So here the splicing is made. Here the splicing or the joint is made, right? So the lap length is basically the distance between two splices. The lap length, it should always, it should not be greater than 1.3 times the splice length. This is provision number 3. So these three provisions are very important. Clear? Now let me tell you how much should be the splice length. How much should be the splice length? That is point number 4. I am rubbing it. I am writing point number 4. The point number 4 is, this is very important, right? Because many questions have been asked from this topic. Now the point number 4 is, listen to this very carefully. Point number 4. The splice length. The splice length, it should be equal to LD, development length, or 30 times the diameter of the reinforcing bar, whichever is greater. Whichever is greater for tension bending. For tension bending. Or you can say for flexural cases, this is the case. The fifth point, this is important, right? Now the second is splice length. It should be equal to 2LD or 30 times the diameter of the bar, whichever is more, greater, I'm writing greater, whichever is greater for direct tension. For direct tension. Okay? Third thing. Sixth point. The splice length, it should be equal to 2 times of LD, right? Sorry, LD or 24 times the diameter of the bar, whichever is greater for compression. For compression. All these 6 points are very important. There are other important things also in slicing, but these are not important. But these 6 points are very important. Where to provide splices, the lap length, right? The splice length, these are the coded provisions which have been given in IS 456 2000. So I hope that you have understood the concept of splicing. And one more important thing I would like to tell you, splicing is also provided when you want to transfer the axial moment, axial force, right? For example, there was some force in this section. Let us say this was a bar and this was also a bar. If you want to transfer the axial force from this bar to this bar, at that all that moment also you provide splicing, right? That's a different aspect, but for the time being, just remember these points. These are very important points. So I hope that you have understood the concept of splicing and some coded provisions also. Now let's meet at the next video and solve one numerical based on the concept of splicing. Thank you.